you given any thought to where this ends?
I told you this on the last one. I left this one once again feeling exhausted, and I did not do a thing.
Well, I hope in a good way.
In a great way.
Satisfied exhaustion.
In just a great way. You've got to be thrilled with how this looks.
Yeah. I mean, we went into it with a lot of hope and ambition, and, you know, hopefully people like what we did. I mean, it's kind of crazy. John Wick Chapter 4 is kind of crazy.
It's not kind of crazy. It's a lot of crazy in the best possible way.
We have lots of new characters, and I think what's fun about the films is the action, but also the humor. Mm-hmm. And I think this version has a lot of heart. Mm-hmm. And not just, you know, with John Wick's journey, but all of the other Donnie Yen's character, Hiroyuki Sanada's, like there's father-daughter themes in this, and brotherhood, and of course, consequences for the choices that you make.
Always consequences. But you led me to my next question. There are some great new additions to this. And with every John Wick film, I leave almost wishing we could explore one of the other relationships more. We never really get the chance. Is there a relationship that you actually wish you could explore more outside of even this film?
I mean, I think it would be fun to kind of go down the Bowery King road to see what those two could cook up.
Bonjour, Monsieur Wick. And welcome.
With Donnie Yen, you know, it's like, good to see you. They give you my name. You know, but you can feel like that there's a bond there and shared experience. And so I would love to go down those roads. And I think we do go down those roads a little bit in this.
I know, but I want more. After 2 hours and 38 minutes, I still wanted more. I asked you this on the last one. Does he ever take off his suit? The question I was most interested in this time is, when does he eat?
Yeah,
I don't think I've ever seen you eat.
Yeah, you don't see John. Well, I drink a little bit.
I get
a little drink once in a while. But yeah, he's walking around the world in one suit. But I changed my suit in this film.
Yeah, you do. It's funny, despite all the stunts, the car stuff, the sword fights, the nunchucks, it was the stairs. If I see you fall down one more flight of stairs, that was the most difficult part for me to digest.
Yeah, I had a wonderful stunt double who was playing John Wick. And Vincent, he's French from Paris. And he had to fall down some stairs. It's pretty epic. I might be the long, anyway.
Yes.
There's an epic.
It never ends.
I know, but it's like that you're getting to see John Wick suffer and get back up again and try again, you know, so.
They just wrapped me quickly. A lot of this movie also involves death. There are discussions about death, the fact that John Wick will never truly find peace until he dies. Have doing these films made you less afraid of death in general, or do you even think about anything like that, or has your perspective on it shifted?
I don't know. I would say John Wick, if I'm looking through death and the movie death in John Wick world, I would say it would be to be more appreciative of life.
Yeah. And as Ian says, such is life.
Such is life.
Just make sure you're having fun.
Yeah.
Hey, congratulations. It's
Thank
just
you.
Another unbelievable film.
Cool. Thank
Seriously.
You.
I heard a rumor. Were you actually supposed to be in John Wick 3?
Yes.
What happened?
During my self-training, for three, I had an injury.
Oh, wow.
So I had to, you know, say, sorry, Chad, sorry, Keanu.
Right.
I cannot make it. It was so sad for me. And but Chad called me that for the four.
Yep.
Okay, you couldn't join us at three, but I make some role for you in four. You should say yes, he said. Why not? Thank you. Thank you.
Well, this was worth the wait to have you in this film. How much credit does Halle Berry get for you being in this movie? Because you're unbelievable in this, but I heard that she played a big part.
Yeah, she played a part in this for sure. Just timing. I was in her previous film, Bruised, on Netflix. And I had a role in there. And Chad Stileski was on set one day, and I worked with him, you know, briefly. And a full circle moment, like I think a year later, they're looking for the tracker, and Chad remembered me from that movie.
Wow.
And so, you know, Halle's connection and hiring me on that, you know, I guess got me this job.
What?
And you also get to work with dogs. How many dogs?
There's a few of them. Oh, you know, when you're working with animals, amazing. They usually have a couple doubles, if not three, four, five of them, just so every animal is safe and making sure that they're not exhausted. And also, they also have different skill sets. You know, some dogs can jump, some dogs can chase, some dogs can speak Spanish. You know, you just never know.
Right.
Got to make sure we have a variety.
I'm interested, obviously, your history goes back decades, and your fight knowledge and your skill is unparalleled. Out of everybody you've worked with, in this film, he basically challenges the Marquis to a duel, one-on-one duel. Of all the people you've worked with, if you had to do a one-on-one duel, who would be the most formidable opponent for you?
Oh, my gosh. This is a great question.
It's a great question. I want to hear this answer.
But, I'm still finding the best enemy. Maybe I'll find forever.
It's because he's taking them all out.
Okay,
that's
next.
What? There's none left.
Apparently, it's yourself, because you got injured, you said, during self-training. So you might be your own.
Yeah.
Girl's like, I can't compete with anybody. I'm going to do it myself now.
Yeah.
Okay. How about you? Out of everybody you've worked with, if you actually had to do a one-on-one duel, who would make you nervous?
Halle Berry.
Oh, for sure.
Halle Berry made me very nervous.
Yeah, for
sure.
She'd
kick ass.
I was curious, in the film you've got, basically, I like to call it a scrapbook, because I'm a big scrapbooker, and I collect photos and all that stuff. Were any of those drawings yours?
That's a really great question, and thank you for recognizing that detail. Yes, I took that notebook home, and I kept it with me, and I put a lot of my own stuff in there.
Oh, wow.
It was really important for me to build that history. So, yes, that notebook was... that's my DNA all over it.
Well, you're a very good drawer.
Ah.
And a good scrapbooker.
Not all of them.
Okay.
Gotta credit some of the art
The bad
team.
Ones weren't yours.
The bad ones were definitely mine. Okay. They were definitely mine.
Come here thinking there is a way out of this world for you, Mr. Wick.
When did Bill Skarsgård become such a jerk?
He's great, isn't he?
He's great.
He's great.
Bill. He's
great. Terrific. I'm trying to think of other things I've
surprised
seen.
Surprised he's not here. He did that wonderful series playing Sweden's most infamous real-life criminal, and he's even more of a jerk in that.
Oh, you know the Netflix?
No, the Netflix. He's great.
Bill's
terrific.
Oh, he's terrible. Have you guys actually, did you ever decide on how your two characters met?
Yeah.
Did you ever agree on that?
We'll let him do this.
Okay.
Now you're giving it to me?
Yeah, well, you
know. So maybe 45 years ago, he says 50, I say 40, so we say 45. We met when
I'm older than you. Yeah. You were a young lad when I met you. Finding his way in Kenya, and I taught you to know the evil ways of the MI5.
So, I mean, he was definitely doing some kind of wet work stuff for CIA, MI5 in Kenya, and I was a teenager, maybe homeless. And some bad stuff went down, and he saved my life.
No, they've known each other forever. Yeah.
Right,
I think and he's his closest friend, I think, whatever.
Yeah. I just didn't know if you had ever agreed on a story. Like, I'm sure you both individually maybe came up with how they might have met, but I didn't know if you ever agreed on one.
Well, nothing, it's not that specific.
Yeah. Organic, wasn't it? That wonderful word?
Yeah.
It was kind of organic. We just,
Because we didn't really talk about it until, like, the last movie.
Well, what's to talk about? Yeah. How did we meet? That's not a scene that goes in a John Wick movie.
Well,
how did we first meet?
I think we first started talking about it. I think we first started talking about it for the junkie for John Wick 3.
Well, that's
right.
Who is this?
The Marquis de Grammont.
You've got kind of a motto in this. You say the line, such is life, more than once. What is your motto, for each of you? What is kind of a rule you live by, or... something that means a lot to you?
Such is life, or, Doris Day, whatever will be, man. Yeah. Que sera, sera.
I'm probably, when in doubt, just tell the truth.
Mm. Always lead with the truth. Have you seen this in its entirety yet?
No, I haven't.
I have.
Not in entirety. He has. I like seeing it next Monday in London with all the bells and whistles, and I want to see my grandkids squirming in their seats.
If he falls down one more set of stairs, I'm going to lose it. Am I right?
No comment.
Okay. It's the stairs, Ian. Oh, my God.
You mean the Sacré-Cœur?
Yes.
While we were waiting at the top,
while
15
you guys
degrees
are hanging
under,
out.
Pissing down with rain, and we're going, Keanu, will you please get up the stairs?
You have no idea what that man went through on the way up. It's insane.
A little far from home, aren't you?
Have you seen it in its entirety?
I have seen it. It's incredible.
I mean, I don't know how they do it.
I think it's the best of the four. Yeah.
I think so, too.
Yeah.
I have to ask you about your character. In fact, the whole movie really starts off by you asking Keanu's character, are you ready?
Are you ready?
Do you think audiences are ready?
No, the audience is not ready.
What do they need to do to get ready?
Strap in.
Okay.
Buckle up.
Yep.
Yes.
Buckle up.
Buckle up. Put on your knee pads. Put on your elbow pads. Put on your face protection and your ear protection.
Yep.
because it's going to get loud.
I'm branching out, spreading my wings.
You know, it's interesting, your character, well, he says he's branching out. He branches out a little bit in this. He's got like a franchise.
Spreading his wings a little bit.
What else do we know about him?
Or
what do you, want to know about him, if anything?
Everything. I want to know everything about the Bowery King. However, I'm not allowed to say.
Okay. Can you tell me what his actual name is? He wasn't born the Bowery King. What name did his parents give him?
What name did his parents give them?
Yes.
Well, if I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Please don't do that. Although, if anyone's going to do it, it would be a good story if it was you. You present Keanu with a suit. I mean, the suits also are super cool in
this.
You call it ballistic chic.
Yes, ballistic chic.
How would you describe your fashion sense?
My fashion sense? Understated royalty?
I don't know. I like that. That's perfect. Understated royalty.
Understated royalty.
Yeah.
You know, Keanu says in this film, yeah, a lot.
A lot.
Is there a word that Lawrence Fishburne overuses that maybe friends and family members say? Why do you have to always say that word? Is there something that you say a lot?
Absolutely.
The word absolutely, or there's absolutely some words that you... Okay.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. You know what? I do 100%. I'm saying that a lot, like 100%.
Yeah,
Why am I doing that?
I'm a Brooklyn guy, and Brooklyn guys, we have a tendency to say absolutely.
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 And so it begins.
3, 2, 1. I can't say enough, obviously, about the stunts, everything that you've done. But I'm curious, when do you know when to end a stunt sequence?
Good question. The answer is I don't.
Yeah.
We don't go into planning. We have ideas about how to quit. It's like a good dance. How do you know when to stop dancing?
Right.
Well, the answer is always when the music stops. So for us, when we choreograph, we over choreograph. I'm an action nerd, so I'll go all day long. I'll have a 2-hour sequence. I don't care. But there's a rhythm to things when you watch them. And the easiest way to do this is not by watching the sequence or the choreography. It's very easy to watch the stunt guys do the thing. Ah, that's a good out right there.
Right.
But you never truly know until you watch the whole movie. Because, again, at the end of the day, the stunt, the sequence, the choreography is just a part of the whole. And we'll go back, and when I do these little edits, we'll watch just the sequence. But when I know I think I've got the sequence to where it links, mm-hmm. that means I got to watch the whole movie. Because the whole movie is the dance. So you just don't know until it's right.
Challenge him to single combat. Win or lose, it's a way out.
So the whole idea, the big idea here is also single combat. Challenge him mm-hmm. to single combat. You've worked with some amazing actors.
Fantastic, luckily.
Pick two of the best. If you could see them go at it in a single combat fight.
Oh my God. That'd be hard for me. I'd have to do like a battle royale and do like semifinals. And
okay,
like that,
pick a couple for me.
You know, I could go back to like, give me Jet Li, Sammo Hung, Jackie Chan. You know, Marcus Aurora, you got like Scott Atkins, you know, Chuck Norris. Oh my God, all these great people from like the 70s and 80s. Gordon Liu, you know, come on, Chow Yun-fat. Let's get him back in there. Steve McQueen, I'd put him against a few.
You got a lot of
Charles Bronson, I got a lot.
Are we going to see another one?
Good question. I truly don't know. We'll see.
What do you hope?
If I could work with Keanu the rest of my life, I'd be good.
Okay, you know what I hope?
So.
I hope yes.
Okay,
just FYI. Not that you care, but anyway.